Welcome back to the Talos Principle. We are back to Hub Area A, as I'm going to call it. So puzzle number one has already been fully completed, including the star, so let's move on to puzzle area number two. Which has got one star, three yellow pieces, and a red piece. And let's see. Are these yellow pieces the pieces I need to get the replay thing? One is, the other is... Actually, no. So two of these pieces will work for the replay thing, but I also need, like, an L shape. Which is not provided here. I don't think I can use the red one. No. Anyway, let's go. Ooh. Whoa. This is beautiful. Oh, look at that moon. You know, it kind of looks like there's parts of the stars missing. And then I realized that I think it's supposed to be covered by clouds, but it really doesn't look like clouds. It just looks like somebody erased the stars. I wonder if there could be a message written in the missing areas in the stars. I don't think so. I mean, well, there could be, but I don't think there is. I just see blobs, I don't see anything distinct enough. Anyway, let's actually look at the ground and see what's around here. Boop boop, beep boop. Science magic. Though the term science has only meant what it does to us for around 600 years, its practice far predates the name. There is evidence pre-Aristotle which indicates soothsayers, mystics, and the like may have employed basic scientific methods to predict the future and confound their benefactors. One anecdote concerns a palm reader who was exposed when two wealthy clients compared their readings and found them to be identical. In 1948, the tendency to discover deep personal meaning in vague descriptions delivered authoritatively was given a name, the Forer Effect. Today is recognized in all contemporary psychology theory. Indeed, that is a real thing. I'm not sure if it's actually pronounced the Forer Effect. It might be like Foray Effect or something. I'm not sure. Weight loss 722. Well, these are the result of web crawls, so this is just like a, I guess, a random web page. So, I mean, we know that the, at least one of the points of this whole project, I don't even know what you'd call it, project, does it have a name? I actually don't know, like, this whole project, what it's called, but regardless, we know that one of the points of this whole project is to preserve the non-biological components of humanity. As much knowledge as possible. All of our books, all of our web pages, everything. So since these are the result of web crawls, I'm guessing these are just literally random clippings from Earth. You know, from humanity. Just random clippings of our knowledge that have been extracted. So, weight loss 722. Weight loss blog, latest entry. Oh man, if there's one thing that's good about inevitable death, it's the food. Yeah, baby, I'm gonna have all the horribly unhealthy food in the world. I'm going to feast on jelly bananas like a crazed monkey on Monkey Christmas. And you know those muffins that have so much chocolate they're basically melting? That's gonna be my breakfast. And burgers for lunch. I'm gonna have burgers so greasy you could use them to lubricate a whole factory. Triple bacon burgers with double cheese and extra onions and mayonnaise and ketchup and mustard and big fat juicy patties. And an oily, thick pizza with spicy salami and barbecue sauce and olives and jalapenos and sour cream. Food coma, here I come. Well, I guess the weight loss blog became a weight gain blog. But yeah, I mean, if you're gonna die, then who gives a damn? Alright, journal entry. Fascinated by Drennan's project. Lovely conversation regarding Talos Principle, Greek philosophy, relevance to current situation. Suggested naming Project Talos. Drennan refused, but name seems to have caught on with the team. Tens of thousands of files coming in every hour. Our whole history. Okay, so I guess it might be named Project Talos. Of which the Talos Principle is obviously an element of that. Okay, let's get a feel for this place before going into any puzzle rooms. Got some paint. Looks like we might have an audio log back there. Let's go plop this down near the center.
I keep having these dreams. Great empty cities. Silent roads stretching for miles. The earth from space, all dark. Not a single light to guide me home. But if someone really came from another world, what would the Earth look like to them? A wilderness? A wasteland? I don't think so. Even after thousands of years, they'd see a world shaped by our hand in every aspect of its being. They'd see the cities and the roads, the bridges, the harbors. And they would say, here lived a race of giants. These dreams, they scare me, but they also remind me that we built all of this.
It is a strange, almost disturbing thought, isn't it? You know, if aliens came to Earth, what would they think? If we found another race, you know, the remnants of another race, what would we think? There's really no way to tell. Until it happens. I have come to see that these mysteries are not all for his children to solve. Only the designer himself could ever truly understand the infinite complexity of his creation. I will gaze at his work and worship. Well, I'm sorry to say this, Faith version 10.6.1008F, but, I think your programming is not very well suited for this place. Because I don't think that's the kind of artificial intelligence they're looking for. Or rather, I don't think that's the sort of real intelligence that they're looking for. I guess they're not really trying to create artificial intelligence, are they? They're trying to create real intelligence. At least in the end. But, yeah, in AI, that would basically bow down and say, this can't be solved, I will gaze at his work and worship. That's not... That sort of a personality just doesn't have enough curiosity. I think we get to play with fans in here for the first time, don't we? I believe we do. There's a chamber back there. I need a box or something to get up there. Unless, can I get on this lip? It rejects me. Well, let's save that for later. I think the star might be back there, actually. I see a blue glow, which might be a blue force field. wonder if any of these torches could be, like, twisted, you know, to open a secret door or something? That's a thing. It's a pretty common puzzle thing. Twistable torches. Okay, let's do a puzzle. Should I go for the red one first? Nah. This one involves fans and boxes. You know, given how far the fan launched me into the air when I used it over in that star area, I'm thinking the possibility of using fans to escape outside of puzzle areas is very, very high. It depends on how I can manipulate them. Because I don't think they're movable, I think they're stationary, so... Yeah. Man on the moon. Whoa. What the? Oh, that's so cool! That is so cool! That's a really detailed model. So you can see the gears that spin underneath before you install the actual fan part. That's so neat! I just love how that looks. Yeah, so much detail on here. Little schematic thing, can't quite read it though, too blurry. Okay, so I'm wondering why... Why do they allow me to pick it up? Okay, so I can use it to weigh that down. I wonder what else I could use it for. Can I detach it? I can. Why would they allow me to do that? There's gotta be a reason they allow you to detach it. Some sort of a use. Okay, so the point at the moment is simply to get to the other side. Okay. Gotcha. Can I be lifted in here while this is on? Hold on. Let me... I think I only need one of these going, so I guess I might as well use the other fan to just weigh it down. And then can I throw the box? Yes, I can. Okay, cool, cool. There's definitely more I can do with it, though. There's a lot of tricks to learn about that fan, I think. Freaking massive key. It's like the size of my hand. Okay. I have a key. What does it open? It's one of those secret things, just like the floppy disk with the kitten pictures, where you have it but it doesn't actually show up in your inventory, so it's kind of like a secret item. Which means you need to keep it in mind because the use of it might not be obvious. As is the case here, because I have no idea where to use a freaking key. Is there a keyhole around here? I ain't see no keyholes. If I reset this... Do I keep the key? No. Good to know. I want to see if I can do some fancy stuff. Like, what can I do with these fans? I mean, why are there two fans? Actually, wait a minute, what power is this one? Oh yeah, the other switch right in front of me, duh. Okay, I mean, I went on the other one, so why don't we just try going on this one? Where does this take me? Oh. Ooh. Can I stop? On top of that pillar? Hmm. Curious. I'm gonna try running in this direction. What the hell? So there's some variance every time I go through it. There's some variance. Whoa. What if I jump when I hit the pillar? Can I get like a little boost? There's something going on with this. It's weird though, I'm just sliding off of the top. What if I toss the box in? Okay, that didn't do much. Yeah, see, I thought the fans put you on an exact trajectory that you couldn't change in the air, but it looks like I have a little bit of air control or something. Yeah. I do. There is some air control. I can't get that back, can I? Nope. Gotta stay on that side, box. How did I I almost stopped that one time. Maybe I should worry about breaking the levels later, but this is really... Whoa, wait, hold on, I just saw a ladder. Yeah, look at that. There's the top of a ladder right there on the other side of that wall. Not sure if you can see it. You can't really see it. You can only see it in the air. Oh, there we go. I really wish I had a flashlight. Looking for somewhere to use the key.
And the words made the world. I am the words. The words are everything. Where the words...
What the heck is that? That's one of those little, mounted binocular things, isn't it? How do I get up there? It's gotta be with a fan, right? I don't see any other way to jump up there. Ooh. I went up there. Well, now I can go around the outside of this entire place. Alright, I'll come back here and try to get to that thing. Let's check out the outside of this place. It might be a little bit premature because I haven't actually explored the other puzzle areas. And by completing the other puzzle areas, I might reveal some things that might give me an idea of what my objective might be out here. It probably doesn't matter, but it could. Let's look for things buried in the ground. Weird helmets. Keyholes. How far can I go out?
In the beginning were the words, and the words made...
I'm thinking the key might be for that binocular thing. Although I'm not sure why I would need a key, usually they just take coins.
The words made the world. I am the words. The words are everything. In the beginning were the words.
I think it's time to head back. Unless... this is probably gonna kill me, but let's try. Yep. Want to see if I can make that jump? Okay. So let's try to get high. Let's get the key first, though. And let's get the key without using the box, because I might need the box for something. Don't want to permanently store it in there. Does it have a keyhole? Can't tell. Okay, possible entrances to that. Need to get up there. I could get to there from here, and I can get to here from the pillar, and I could jump to it from these pillars. And those pillars are things I have stopped on, although fallen off of promptly, so... Let me just keep trying it until I fall onto it. Two hundred tries later. Why is it bouncing me off? I think it's some sort of, like, faux momentum thing. I guess it's supposed to be momentum, but this game doesn't really have that. I mean, does this game really have a friction system? I don't really know. That bounce is crazy, it's like auto-jumping for me. You know what? Maybe I don't need to stop on that. Maybe I just need to jump on it and keep going to the left. Let's try it. Yes! Oh! Almost had it. But yeah, that's definitely it. So I'm gonna bounce on it no matter what. I'm not gonna be able to stop on it, but I can bounce off of it and then go on to the other part. The physics here are very loose. These aren't exactly precision platforming physics here. Oh, almost made it. I would cut, but I know as soon as I cut, I'm gonna make the very next jump, so screw it. Oh, ah, damn it! I think I actually had it, and then I messed it up. I do have air control, but it's surprisingly little. I'm constantly holding left the entire- Oh, damn it! Ah! It can be done. I know it. Okay, I guess I will actually cut. I'm probably gonna make it on the very next one, but who cares? I'll be right back. Okay. Whew. Just made it. I did attempt to do something else, by the way. Something that unfortunately failed. I was thinking, maybe I could drop the box on the pillar in midair. As I was going by it. So then it'd be up on the pillar, so the next time I went through here, I would hit the box and it would stop me? It might be possible, but I just kind of messed it up and accidentally threw the box over. So, whoops. Keep a lookout for any floppy disks. Alright, what are you? Oh yeah, look at that. Keys, please. Keys only. Insert the key, pull the handle, watch. Property of Ian. So that is what the key was for. I think I'm going to use it to gaze up into the moon. Let's find out. Okay, so I can aim it wherever I want. Cool. Where's the moon? Can I zoom in and out? I don't think so. Nope, looks like I can't. There it is. Is there a man on the... What? I was gonna say, is there a man on the moon? But no, there's a freak... What? What the hell? That is so cool. There's a connector. Are there any more? Oh my god, that is awesome. Can you actually see that with a naked eye? You can! Yeah, you can actually see with the naked eye. You don't need this thing, but it's really hard to notice it, and to even think to look there without it. That is so freaking cool. Okay. Well, that's gonna probably help with getting the star. And could even help with some of the other puzzles, too. Because I can access that from, I guess, any puzzle room, really. Alright, that might not be all there is to see, though. Anything else? Like, what if we gaze at the distant islands? I wish I could zoom out, because it's really hard to get my sense of place when I'm zoomed in so much. Can I turn this thing 360? Seems like it. No, not quite. That's the limit. On that side, let's go the other way. And that's the limit on the left side, okay. Doubt I'm gonna find anything else. Quick look around. No, I think that's it. That is so freaking cool. Okay, well, while we're up here, what else can we get up to? Just make sure there's nothing hidden on top of here, okay. Looks like that's the end from here. If I get down on this wall, that doesn't really take me anywhere. So yeah, it looks like that's all you can access from over here. It's just that little viewing binocular thing. Okay, let's go do a different puzzle. That's the red one. Moonshot. You don't say. Does that imply that I'm supposed to use the moon? I wonder if you kind of have to find that thing on the moon. You'd have a hard time finding that if you didn't know it was there. I mean, it is there, but the activation region is like 4 pixels. Alright, what are we doing here? Go straight up. Does that mean you can hover? So could I hover a connector in the air? Okay, so the end goal is to get red power over here. Gotcha. Got two boxes and one connector, not counting the connector on the moon. So, what happens if I do this? That does not hover as much as I thought it would. So the extra weight of holding the box is actually not accounted for in your hovering height. Because since I weigh less when I drop this, you'd think I would go up higher. But I don't. What if I put it underneath me? Okay. I notice, rather suspiciously, that the power source and the destination are both barely covered at the normal hover height, which suggests that perhaps I'm supposed to put it on top of a block. And then put the block in the fan. Booyah! That is freaking cool. However, I think I know a cooler way. Or do I? I want to use the moon. But actually, can I? I mean, I only have one connector to play with. Not really. No, I don't think I can. Looks like I'm unlocking a new tool. It's a dude with his hands up holding a thing. I don't know what that is. Is that a skateboard? Am I gonna get to skateboard? That'd be pretty cool. Wouldn't it be cool if I, like, got a device that would allow me to, like, go up and down these laser beams? Like some sort of a laser beam, what's the name of those things? I mean, like, slide down a rope? But not with your bare hands, with some sort of a wheel thing? I don't know what they're called. Anyway, that's unlocked, so how about this? There we go. That's so cool. Alright, so now the moon has red power. Whoa! What the fuck? This? There's something up there. Aside from just that symbol, there's something up there. What is that? Oh my god. Is that musical cue like a reference to something? I'm not quite sure what it is, but I feel like it probably is. Okay, so I think that viewing thing was not only just to see that there is a connector on the moon, but I think it's also to turn it around and then go back there and look and see what that thing is up there, because there's something up there. Some roundish object. Let's go see. This is so cool. now I have to do this again. Oh god. I do still have the key, right? Yeah. See, I was thinking the thing on the moon was just to get red power that you can get from any puzzle room, but I think... I don't know if you actually can. It's kind of at such a extreme angle that I suspect it's only available from that one place. I think the point of it is just to turn the moon around and get all that stuff to happen. Oh, there we go. Alright, what is going on up there? Oh, you know, that symbol looked familiar. This is a portal reference, isn't it? Isn't that, I don't remember the name of the dude. It's the little robot thingy. Voiced by the tall dude whose name I forgot, right? Stephen Merchant? I think. It's looking at me. Okay, I think that's just a reference. I don't think that's meant to help me solve any puzzles. Very, very cool, nonetheless. The tomb. The tomb. Hello. Okay, so I don't need to actually use a box to jump up on the outside. I can get there from here. This is the blue glow that I saw. Just need a jammer. Hopefully there's a jammer in here. What do you know? There's a jammer. Okay, so I get that I'm supposed to retrieve these sigils. I just don't get why. Sure, the loud voice is telling me to, but this world of his has no context, no purpose, and no foundations from which to construct them. I'm convinced there are answers here if we look hard enough. We have to work together on this. I just thought of something. I should probably leave a message about the moon thing, right? Can I? Can I make a special message about the moon? See, I noticed the one time when I left a message about the axe, there was a special message specifically about the axe. Like a contextual message, whereas these are just generic. So do I need to put a message in a place where the special message actually shows up? But if so, then where would I put it? Next to the key, perhaps? You know, what wall would give a hint about the moon? I think maybe next to the key. And I guess by doing this, what I'm doing by leaving these messages is helping the other AIs behind me, the other AIs to become smarter. Which is the goal of this whole thing, right? Pass on as much knowledge as possible. There's no special message. Strange. Oh, right, I'm carrying an item. Yeah, I guess we can reset. It's only gonna reset the room, right? No, it reset the moon! I guess that's fine. Don't think I need it. Well, I'm not sure where to leave the message. Okay, there's red power, but I don't have a connector. So let's see what's in here. There's gotta be a connector that I can take back, right? Yes. I think these walls are gonna give me trouble, aren't they? What do you know? Probably not how you're intended to do it. Waiting for the symbol to turn white for both? I don't think it's gonna happen, though. Nope. Alright, where would it have to be? It'd have to be in that corner. Or... it just needs to be a bit further out, I suppose. Yeah, this should be fine, right? Just in the center. Oh, and of course the pillar's in the way. Well, dicks. Dastardly puzzle. I don't think that's enough. No, it has to be in the center. Or on the right side. Look at how far away it is. That's just to get back out, so that's irrelevant, right? Well, you know what? Hold on. Maybe this is relevant. Hello? Ooh. Whoa. Use the bed? Okay. What? Do androids dream of electric sheep? I think that's what that's telling me. Oh my god. That is amazing. That is beautiful. That is a work of art. Now, let's go the other way. Ah, that is where the star is, and it does need red power. Well, not necessarily. It needs red power or it needs a jammer. So if I can get that jammer on the other side, that would be useful. If I do want to use red power, then I either need a red power source that I can access from here, or I need two connectors. One here, and then one to go out here. There is the moon. It does start to turn, but it does have power for a while. So I could give it red power from over there again. But I would need two connectors here. But that is a possibility. Alright, well, I can forget this for now. Alright. Now that I have this jammer, I think that just solves the problem, doesn't it? Yeah, there we go. I wasn't supposed to use red power. Okay, if I want the star, I think I need to use the jammer to open up... No, I definitely need to use the jammer to open up this, because you can't open this with red power. So that has to be the use of the jammer. If I want to connect to the red power with what I know now, then what I would need would be... two connectors. And I only have two connectors, so I would need to get both of them out. Can I? Can I do that? Okay, well, that would allow me to get one. Okay, so I have one jammer and one connector. But how do I get the connector out? Oh, I know. Jam this from the other side. Okay. I believe that's all we need. Yeah, okay. So now I just use this jammer to open this up. We are going to use the moon. I'm gonna have to be quick, though. Alright, so the first one simply goes here. Second one connects to that, and connects to the moon. Alright, so that's all good to go. Now the only thing I need to do is just supply power to the connector on the moon. Ooh, computer's beeping. It's got new infos for me. Okay. Here we go. And we're off. Go go, 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 go. I can hear the moon turning. Wait a minute, what? Why isn't it getting red power? Shouldn't that work? Is that not how connectors work? You supply red power to a connector and then you put another connector to the connector? I mean, I just realized there's another way to solve this. But, I don't understand why this doesn't work. Okay, well, I guess the way we're supposed to solve this is just to lift the connector up in the air. Yeah, I don't get why that's not supplying power. Weird. But anyway, this should work. Star achieved. What have you got for me? Is my friend back? Ah, my friend is back. Support session opened. Here's what I've been wondering while you were off carrying out commandments. You say that consciousness is some kind of functional system. Arrange bits of matter in the right order and out springs sentience. That's all very well on paper, but if what counts is what something does, not what it's made of, then couldn't you and I design a series of tin cans on strings that qualified as being conscious? Functional system. Okay, yeah, that does sound pretty absurd now that you mention it. Not sure I'd go that far. What about a computer program? Suppose we built a perfect simulation of the brain, only it was made of transistors, not neurons. Wouldn't that be conscious? It would. So what's the difference between the computer and the tin cans? They're both just man-made systems. Computers can remember things. So can tin cans. Expertly arranged. Try harder. Okay. I can't name the difference, but there is one. If that's what you really think, wouldn't we save ourselves an awful lot of time if you just admitted that consciousness is whatever very particular idea you've decided you like the sound of, and drop all this nonsense about complex systems? Yeah, I have no idea. Alright, you're right, this idea is too broad. But then we're back to where we started. Do you want to propose an alternate account? Or alternative account? Sure. Fine, but I won't allow you to lead us round in circles on this for the rest of eternity. I will take your next answer. So do take a moment to think about it this time. Do I want to go back to a complex functional system? We just did that. Consciousness is made of neurons. No. I mean, it arises out of neurons, sure. At least in humans. But in a computer, it obviously would not be neurons, but rather their equivalents. Consciousness is not part of the physical world. That's true. Consciousness is not part of the physical world. It arises out of the physical world, but it's not part of it. Yeah, it's not a thing in the physical world that you can see or touch, but it does arise out of it. You've suggested that consciousness is not part of the same world as ordinary physical things. That means you can't weigh it, you can't throw it around or cut it into pieces. It's completely beyond the laws of physics, right? Well, yeah, you can't cut it or throw it around or cut it into pieces or whatever, sure. It's true. Completely beyond the laws of physics, though? No? Well, it's bound to physical matter, so in that way it does depend on the laws? Reality? It's weighed down, it's roped down by reality because it depends on physical things, even if it is not itself physical? So, wrong? Look, you can't have your cake and eat it. The soul, or the immaterial realm, or whatever you want to call it. If it obeyed the laws of physics, then the physicist would have claimed it years ago. If it walks and talks like a physical thing, it's a physical thing. You need to decide which side your bread is buttered on. Okay, well, consciousness itself is definitely not physical. No. Good. Now, the library is fairly consistent on the view that physical events are caused by other physical events. If you move your legs, it is because of the interaction between your neurons and your nervous system. But if consciousness is beyond the laws of physics, how can happiness physically make you jump for joy? Consciousness is physical, why is it so unlike everything else? But consciousness isn't physical. How can happiness physically make you jump for joy? It can't, it just feels like it can. Well, no, it can. I don't even understand these answers. Happiness cannot physically make you jump for joy, it just feels like it can? What? Well, I suppose that's true. It's not happiness itself that makes you jump for joy, it's the fact that you told your limbs to jump. Very clever. But do you see that to explain your, dare I say it, hastily constructed belief system, you have rather thrown the baby out with the bathwater. Consciousness that does nothing at all is hardly conscious as you claim to know it. Would you like to stick with that line, or reel your neck in? God, I don't know. Consciousness that does nothing at all. No, it does do something. Consciousness is mysterious by nature? That's not even an answer. It's just wishy-washy bullcrap. But it is mysterious, that is true. Sure, it's mysterious? This ain't gonna fly. Let me put it another way, then. The law of conservation of energy is the foundation of modern physics. It states that the total energy in the universe never changes. Now compare a universe where you jump for joy and one where you decide not to. The former has more total energy in it, because the energy for you to jump wasn't caused by something physical. But your non-physical mind... wasn't caused by something physical, but your non-physical mind. But according to physics, that's impossible. I think that either you have to reconsider your position or deny the entirety of physics. Though be warned, if this place turns out to be built on physics, who knows what the ramifications of doubting it may be. This place is definitely not built on physics. I think I've demonstrated that by walking through walls. The total energy in the universe never changes. When we decide to jump has more energy in it because the energy for you to jump wasn't caused by something physical, but instead by your non-physical mind. Sorry, but this place ain't built on physics. I renounce physics. Be it on your head.
Do not think I know not the deceiver slithering through the hidden words. His wisdom is hollow and born of despair. Do not let him tangle you in his webs of delusion. Have faith in me, and his petty illusions will fall away like nightmares in the morning's light.
Looks like that's the end of our conversation. Be it on your head. Still, the alternatives are equally unconvincing. How consciousness can be so intimately familiar to you, and yet so obscure, I just don't understand. This is in reply to what Elohim just said. Don't mind him. He's just worried that if you ask too many questions, you'll start to see through his shtick. Stick with me, and the sky will quite literally be the limit. At any rate, I'd like you to think a bit harder about all this and get back to me. I'm sure there's still progress to be made. Okay, well, I've discovered the moon, found the gold star, so I think I've pretty much found the secrets of this place. Just need to complete this red puzzle. But I think I'll save this one for the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.